Important topic. It's not just the eyes that cause eye strain. There are a lot of conditions which non-ocular problems which can produce eye strain, which also we must have at the back of our mind when we look for any cause for eye strain. So over to Dr. Vinod Kumar, who is the Chief Ophthalmic Surgeon of Sai Darshan Eye and ENT Clinic, Calicut.
Thank you, Dr. Laila, Madam. Thank you, AAOS, for giving me an opportunity to be a speaker here. So you would have heard a lot about the ocular causes of eye strain from the previous speakers. And usually when an individual develops feeling of eye strain, they consult an ophthalmologist first, and who after a careful and complete evaluation will not come across any ocular cause for their eye strain. So we have to ask them, probe further, still we pounce upon, and we may pounce upon some non-ocular causes of eye strain about which I am going to talk. I have no financial disclosure. So what is eye strain? All jobs require some effort from our eyes. But in certain situations, it is the eyes that work overtime during our waking hours, especially so in case of computer professionals, long distance drivers, even doctors who are into the latest medical technology like the EMR and robotics, etc. So coming to the non-ocular causes of eye strain, we have a lot of causes, and the list is like posture, lighting, environmental causes, sleep, psychological, sinus infections, hormonal, and pharmacological. So we'll see each one in detail. So posture. Maintaining a comfortable posture during work is very important in preventing eye strain. Again, the most important for computer professionals, drivers, and medical personnel working on microscopes. And studies have shown that bending forwards over the computer or a microscope leads to more effort in stabilizing the gaze, which can increase the blood flow in the trapezius muscle as well as in the orbicularis oculi, which in turn leads to increased blinking and causes more forward bending of the eyes, of the head, to see more clearly, and this can lead to eye strain. Even it has been found that heart rate increases during computer use as compared to rest. So bending forwards towards a computer screen shows an increased work speed, indicating a stress response. So these all causes eye strain. So correct posture is very important. So what is the correct posture for PC users? The back should be straight. The feet should be planted flat on the ground. The arms should be tucked on either side with the elbow at an angle of 100 to 110 degrees. The head elevated and chin up. The keyboard should be right in front, and the top of the screen should be at eye level. And the comfortable viewing distance will be around 20 to 30 inches, and the monitor should be slightly tilted back around 10 to 15 degrees, so that when you are looking at the center of the screen, your line of sight is perpendicular to the surface of the screen. Also, the bottom of the viewable screen, viewable area of your monitor should never be more than 25 to 30 degrees below your line of sight. And laptops are found to be the most notorious in causing eye strain. As the posture, we cannot have such a posture using a laptop. So laptops are very notorious for causing eye strain. For driving, these two pictures show the correct posture as well as the wrong posture. While driving, you should make sure the posture is comfortable with a good back support, straight spine, head looking straight, and not push forwards. Good thigh support is also essential for long drives. And other factors affecting the eyes while driving are a clean windscreen and a clean spectacles for people using spectacles. And next comes a very important thing about the non-ocular cause, it's the lighting. It's always a problem, and we can never have an ideal lighting as given in the literature, but we need to have a comfortable ambience with very less reflections. So should we have a proper lighting of the work area which reduces or eliminates eye strain? And sunshine is a natural mood elevator in a house, but in an office, sunlight streaming through the windows directly behind or in front of the computer creates a lot of contrast problems, shadows, and glare. So what is the remedy? Adjust the amount and direction of outdoor light in office by closing the blinds, shades, or drapes to match the natural illumination. And place the computer monitor such as to prevent natural light from bouncing off the screen. And you should have a low level and glare-free ambient lighting in the office and tone down excessive or intense ceiling lights. And indirect light fixtures that hang from the ceiling are very effective in distributing the illumination evenly. And you can also use light diffusers like frosted globes, which gives out a diffuse light. And when you're having a desk lamp to read the material, it should be on the side of the computer and ensure that the light shines on the working papers instead of the computer monitor. And again, you have to adjust the computer screen brightness display, and which should be equal to the office illumination to reduce possible eye strain. And while driving, you can use good quality sunglasses, which can prevent unwanted glare due to direct lights, and also it keeps away reflected light, which is very annoying, especially from water bodies and some mirrors or something on the shops. And night driving, you can actually use night vision goggles, which is easily and cheaply available in the online market. And next, coming to environmental factors. The dry environment in an air-conditioned room is also a major factor causing eye strain. And most of the offices and automobiles are air-conditioned, and this makes the ocular surface dry, causing eye strain. Also, air pollution in a dusty or smoky environment also causes eye strain by causing ocular surface disease. So you can use some air humidifiers in the office, the cheapest one being a mug of water, or you can go for ones in the market, which are very expensive, but you can still use them. And lubricant eye drops, as was explained earlier, can be used as and when required, and definitely it's helpful in all these conditions. And while driving, you should keep the AC vents directed away from the face, preferably below the chin level, because a direct blast of air can even cause dryness of the eyes. And next is sleep, that is rest. Rest is very much needed for every organ to function without trouble. And eyes feel the lack of adequate rest with symptoms of grittiness and irritation. Taking adequate breaks in between work is a very good way to prevent eye strain. And the 20-20 rule is very effective in computer users. That is, for 20 minutes working on the computer, take a break for 20 seconds and look far beyond 20 feet, and you can add one more 20, blink 20 times. So that's 20-20-20 rule. So, and during long drives, take a lounge and don't forget to walk around. That is, even I like to go for long drives. So what I do is, whenever I feel a little strain, I get down, stop the vehicle, get down, walk around a bit. Can blink your eyes, stretch your body, and walking around a bit can increase the blood circulation and can relieve the eye strain. And once you are comfortable, you can again start your drives. And then comes the psychological factors. Anxiety, actually the anxious individuals have high levels of circulating adrenaline. This circulating adrenaline gives us difficulty in focusing because the pupillary actions and gives blurred images. And this increases eye strain. And because when we see blurred, we try to again bend forwards to see clearly. And again, all the gaze stabilization things come into play and eye strain increases. And also job-related stress, again, can be the same. That is, you tend to do things faster, so again, bend forwards. So again, for this remedy for these anxious individuals, other than medication, is yoga and meditation is effective in dealing with work-related stress. Coming to hormonal, pregnancy has a lot of hormonal effects, and these can cause dry eyes, changes in refraction due to changes in corneal refractive index, or changes in accommodation of the crystalline lens. And such pregnant women, visually we don't prescribe glasses at that time because it keeps on changing, refraction keeps on changing. You can explain to them this is a problem, so you can give them again lubricants and postpone the checkup after the delivery, and maybe at least around 3 to 4 months after delivery. And increased adrenaline, again in the circulation, as I told earlier, causes a lot of stress and eye strain. Sinus infections, headaches and eye pain are common in individuals working on computers. So sinus infections are a major cause if we exclude refractive error. Sphenoid and ethmoid sinuses are the major contributors for this eye strain. A trial of steam inhalation, oral antibiotics, and decongestants can be tried. If not improving, you can send them to an ENT opinion. And next, coming to some pharmacological factors, there's a whole list of drugs which can cause eye strain. But due to blockage, paucity of time, I'm not giving the whole list. But you can ask the patient whether they are on any medication. So oral contraceptive pills, hormone replacing therapy for menopause, antihistamines, antidepressants, isotretinoin for acne, all these are found to cause, even digoxin has been found to cause eye strain. So these are the references. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Vinod. In this, the lifestyle of the patients and doctors have changed to such an extent that we don't take a proper history. As the first speaker has said, the human touch and asking for stress-related problems and lot of problems which can induce eye strain and stress-related headache can also contribute to this. So history taking is very important to know when exactly, what exactly causes this eye strain. And recently I remember the dermatologist, a friend of mine, he was saying a patient who had an allergy which comes on and off at reasonably frequent intervals, and after quite a number of times it so occurred that it was due to the dye used by the wife on the same side of the face. He used to get recurrently every month. So history taking is very important. I think we have to pay attention to a lot of subtle changes which occur during the habits incurred during our work. So with this, we come to the end of our session, addressing eye strain. If you have any questions to the speakers. Thank you all.
I would like to add on one or two points in presbyopic correction. One is some few points which are usually not addressed by the opticians, despite the patient telling a complaint about it. One is the pantoscopic tilt, which causes a significant amount of difficulty. That like in the present day scenario, like getting up on escalators or going down the stairs, the pantoscopic tilt is very important. So that gives a lot of eye strain also. They have reading problems. Pantoscopic tilt is under addressed in most of the cases. Second thing is the presbyopic lenses by various companies, that fitting height is slightly different. So when that centration is not correctly done, the fitting height might, the interpupillary distance, everything will be correct. But if the given charts of the companies are compared with the presbyopic glass given to the patient, sometimes the near segment might be either cut off more or it might be increased. So that will cause eye strain. The patients will not be able to read properly for near, but they will not be able to tell you in so many words that this is the problem. So these two issues are frequently under addressed in eye strain. So those are two things.
Can you use the mic?
I have a patient, a young female, over cylinder, almost -3 to -3.5. Right eye -3.5 cylinder and left eye -3.5 cylinder. I prescribe it, and whenever he use glass, his lids open clearly and he is happy. But when he remove the glass, the lid becomes, she couldn't open the eyes. This main complaint is this.
You mean to say when he is not using glasses, he has sort of ptosis?
No ptosis is there.
He can't open his eyes.
When she remove, she can't open.
Tolerate. Yeah, I think once, especially astigmatic correction, this is a large astigmatism.
Yes,
you're
yes.
Talking about -3.5 cylinder is a very, quite a large cylindrical correction. So long as they don't use glasses, they have blurred vision.
Yes.
That's all. they don't have any other problem. But once you have corrected, and this sort of large astigmatism, I think it has to be used all the time.
Yes.
Whenever it is removed, they get all the problems, which was not there until the spectacle correction was done. So I think it's not uncommon to see that they have problems when they are not using glasses. This is quite a large astigmatic correction.
So and most often,
I see this. Whenever I put the glass on her face, she nicely opened. When she removed it in front of mine, she closed it. And she told me that I am unable to open. I don't want this. So please get rid of this.
The ones
I told her that you have to choose whether you want a clear vision or you want to open your eyes, like freely. So tell me.
No, it's just like getting used to convenience. If we use a stone grinding this thing and at home and shift over to a mixie, initially, like we find the convenience of that, so we'll never want to go back to the stone grinding technique. So that's the same thing here, and most probably they'll be trying to squeeze the eyes to get a pinhole effect when they're not using the glasses. So that might be another reason why they're. So it's just a matter of convenience, and children are very quite fast in learning that this is something good for them.
Almost 17 years.
17 years, okay, fine.
Actually, the squeezing produces, of course, some squeezing on the cornea, plus it will produce a sort of pinhole effect to see clearly. So that is the reason when I've seen many of my colleagues also who take off the glasses and then starts looking like this. So that is because they can see better by squeezing. So
small squeezing, it's no problem. Okay, thank you.
Yes. So thank you all.